What's going on, you guys? It's your boy Lloyd here, and today we're going to be talking all about the lies women tell men. So this is kind of a continuation from the last video I did, which is basically things that women think, but rarely, if ever, tell guys. And so this is going to be something that is really common lies that I've seen a lot of times. You know, this video, let's be real, this video could be like 10 hours long if I wanted it to. You know, there's so many, if anyone said something, somebody's lied about it. But these are the things that I've seen most commonly that pop up. So I'm going to talk about the lie that women say. We're going to talk about seven of them. I'm going to talk about why women lie about this, and then also what you should do about it. So we're trying to make this practical as well. You know, should you call them out? Should you play along? You know, what should you do in these circumstances? So yeah, these are the big ones, guys. So let's get right into it. Okay, thing number one is her body count. Women are probably going to lie about the sexual number of sexual partners that they've had, okay? This is purely and simply because she doesn't want to look like a slut to you. Although sometimes I've heard about women telling guys that they're virgins because they don't want to hook up with them or something like that. So, you know, it depends. But typically, the number's probably going to be a little bit higher than what she's saying, okay? I remember one time I was, after I had sex with this girl, she told me her number was like around 100. And for me, that was probably pretty accurate. You know, why would somebody lie about that? I mean, that number's so high. So that girl is probably an anomaly, okay? You know, most women's count is definitely not that high. But if she says that she's only had sex with like 3 or 4 guys, maybe the number's a little bit higher than that. Because a lot of times women won't count vacation sex, they won't count if the guy doesn't come, or whatever the rule is, I don't know. Different things people tell themselves in their head. Should you call them out on it? No. In fact, I probably wouldn't even ask this question to begin with. It's not really important to focus on, and if you do ask it, you know, trust me, you probably don't want to know that number. Okay, so let's talk about number two. Number two is, I don't care about looks. Women say this all the time, okay? I don't care about looks. I'm not interested in looks. I want, you know, more connecting with somebody, okay? Yes, she does care about connecting with somebody, but saying she doesn't care about looks at all, probably not, okay? So the good news is for a lot of you guys out there, women care about other things more than looks, but they do care about looks a lot more than they're willing to admit. Okay, so especially in Western culture, women care about looks a lot more than women in traditional societies. Women in traditional societies don't really care about looks at all. They just kind of want a guy with status and money. But here they do. And, you know, even if she says she doesn't, she probably does. Okay, now if you're a guy who's not very good looking, you feel like you're ugly, don't worry. There's plenty of other qualities you can enhance and you can do very, very well. You can date so many different types of women by being an awesome guy, not just from your looks. Okay, and that's stuff that I talk about on this channel. Just know if she says she doesn't care about looks, okay, she's probably lying. Try and look your best. Okay? All right, number three, I have a boyfriend. Women lie about this all the time, and I'm kind of happy that they do because it's a nice, polite way to reject you when they don't want to talk to you and you don't have to feel bad about yourself, okay? So if a girl tells you she has a boyfriend, whether she does or she doesn't, basically she's just saying she doesn't really want to talk to you, okay? Or doesn't really want to talk to you right now. So I don't really take offense for it. It's fine. There's times where people don't want to talk to people. It's totally okay. Now, do I call her out on it? No, okay? Because I want to talk to people that want to talk to me. Whatever the reason was, she's not interested right now. So I move on and I talk to somebody who is. That's how a high value man thinks about things. Okay, number four, I'm not looking for a relationship. Okay, this is typically if the girl's into you and she doesn't want to scare you off. And sometimes single girls will say this too when they're just, you know, maybe they're getting a little frustrated with their dating lives and they don't really want to deal with it. But, you know, the truth is if she found the right guy, yeah, she would. Okay, so usually when women say this, they're not trying to scare you off. Now, when a girl says this to you, how should you react? Should you be like, yeah, really? Tell me what you really want. No, don't call her out on it because it's just gonna cause problems, okay? So take what she says, believe it, but just know that in the back of your head, like, you know, if things start to change, if feelings start happening, that's usually what happens when you've been seeing a girl who likes you, who you've been sleeping with, or you've been dating for a long time. You know, feelings do come up. We're only human. So just know that maybe right now she's cool with things the way they are, but in the future, that may change. Okay, lying about her interests. One time I was hanging out with this girl and I was talking about how I'm really into martial arts and I like mixed martial arts a lot. You know, I like the UFC and that sort of stuff. And she's like, oh yeah, I'm really into that too. Like I love Conor McGregor and all, you know, all that stuff. So then I later on, she was hanging out at my place. I put on a fight. We started watching it. And she's like, why are you watching this? And I go, well, I like fighting. And you told me you like fighting too. And she goes, oh, okay. And I could just see the gears turning. She realized, she's like, oh shit, I lied about that. Now I got to watch this. Now, did I call her out on it? No. Could I have called her out on it? Maybe. I might have been able to tease her about it. But I wanted to watch the fight. So I rolled with it. All right, I've been really busy. That's something that women say a lot of times if they are, you know, they're kind of like not texting you back, maybe they're ghosting you or whatever. Oh, sorry, I've just been really, really busy. Okay, has she been really busy? Maybe, but probably not. So in this circumstance, should you call them out on it? I don't think you should call them out on it, but it generally means that you're just not a big enough there's something else that was a bigger priority than you at that moment. So it could mean that she's really, really not interested in you, but it could also mean that maybe something big was happening that she had to focus on. I mean, if you're just some random guy that she met or matched with on Tinder, yeah, the other stuff is going to take priority over that. Does it mean she's not going to go out with you at all? No, I think there's a chance that she could. So you have to really make a judgment call on that based off of kind of how things have gone previously, and if you feel like she's into you and you know that you're just there's something going on with her, then yeah, maybe continue. But I would say if she's always saying that she's busy, she's not that busy. Okay, she just doesn't want to talk to you. All right, I'm not trying to date. Yeah, this is something that women say quite a bit. So they'll say it for a couple of reasons. If she's single and maybe she went through a bad breakup or something like that, and she's emotionally telling herself that she's not ready to date right now, then yeah, maybe sometimes they'll say that. Also too, if you're talking to her and she's like, oh, I'm not ready to date right now. I'm not interested in dating, blah, blah, blah. I need to work on myself. She just doesn't want to date you. That's usually what it means. Maybe there's some emotional stuff going on with her that might not be your fault, but in general, that's usually what she means. Now, it's not your job to try and change her mind. Oh, yes, yeah, I'm sure if you found the right guy, you'd be willing to date. Yes, that's probably true, but she's told you what she told you. Just, you know, I'd probably move on to someone who's not dealing with so many issues right now. You know, it's not your job to fix them. It's not your job to make it better. If she gives you that kind of answer, then just take it as it is and move on to a girl who is, who does want to date. Okay. So cool. Hopefully you've seen from this that, you know, usually calling women out on their lies doesn't really do too much. I mean, that's something that I did in the past, had very little success with it. So just roll with a lot of these and kind of know in the back of your mind that she might not be telling the truth. Now, what you should look for is you should look for the way a woman behaves or her actions, okay? Actions speak a lot louder than words and they rarely, rarely lie. Meaning if you're talking to a girl at the bar, she says she's really into you, she thinks you're attractive, you know, she'd love to go out on a date with you and gives her a phone number, but she won't follow you around the bar, you know, is that woman that into you? I'm not sure, okay? I know that if a girl moves around with me, she's saying with her actions that she's into me. She might say things that she doesn't like me. She thinks I'm I'm too cocky. She's, you know, being really negative all the time. With her words, she's saying that she's not into me, but with her actions, she's leaving her friends and following me around the bar. That girl's interested in me. So pay attention to the actions. They speak a lot louder than words and you'll be a lot better off for it. Okay, cool. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you made it to the end, consider subscribing. Come out with videos like this every single week. And yeah, if you're looking to get coached by me personally, I have a classroom going on right now, a mastermind program that's will probably work out pretty well for you. But in order for me to find out if you'd be a good fit, there's a form down below. Click on the link, fill out the form, and we'll get back to you. Thanks a lot, you guys. Good luck out there.